Welcome. On today's episode of DAX Made Easy, we're diving into SUMX and SUM. By the end of this tutorial, you'll have a complete understanding of how to use these functions. So let's dive into Power BI Desktop. All right, so here we are. The page we're looking at is available in the description of this video, so you can follow along. I highly encourage you to do that. What we're gonna have is the SUM function and the SUMX function. We're gonna go through both of them. You will get how these things work at the end of this video. So by the definition, the SUM function adds all of the numbers in a column, and the SUMX returns the sum of an expression evaluated for each row of the table. I'm gonna talk you through a very simple example to understand this. Note that the SUM function is gonna say, give me a column you wanna count up. The SUMX function is gonna say, give me a table, and I'll go through every row of that table and perform an aggregate SUM function. But it's easier to show than just to talk about. So what we have is a set of data, and the data is a bunch of orders. Essentially, every order has an ID, an order line, and every order has a price and a quantity. So if something was $7 or three of them, the total sale for that is $21. We're gonna go through that process. By default, anytime you have a measure, it's gonna automatically do an aggregate of some kind. What I mean by that, so on the right-hand side, I'll turn on my highlighter. You'll see in this data model, there's measures. So this is just what's already in the data. It's that price column that we just were looking at. So I'm gonna add price. It's gonna by default, add it and aggregate it up. And then I'm gonna add quantity. It doesn't have total sales. It doesn't have the SUM function. So we're gonna go about doing that. Let's do it here. I'm gonna actually delete what I've created here and I'll remake them. One second here, one, delete, two, delete. Here's a quicker way to delete something if you're curious. Just open up the model, go to the calculations. And again, these other ones are here because there's gonna be more videos, lots of DAX Made Easy videos. But let's remove these so it's just fresh. We wanna go through this process together. So here we are. What I'm gonna do is make a new calculation, new measure, nice and big. I'm gonna call this the sum of the price. And very simply, the way this works, I'll type in sum, it will auto-populate to get sum. And at this point, it's gonna ask me for the column. I wanna pick price. You can see adds all the numbers in a column, very simple. After you create this, it's gonna be a separate calculation. What I like to do is put all my calculations into folders. So to do that, if you always go back to the model view, you can pick a folder, and I'm gonna call this sum and SUMX. Cool, so if I add this, anytime you create a calculation as well, you'll see lots of different numbers and things. If you click it, you can format it. So I want it to be currency and zero. Very simple. So what this does is now this thing called sum price, well, it evaluates and matches exactly with the sum of the price. Makes sense. So let's keep going. I'll do something now with SUMX that's gonna give the same result. Eventually, we're gonna get into different results, and that's where you're gonna understand the concept of SUMX. You gotta go through this process to track all the way to get to what SUMX really means. So make a new measure. I'm gonna call this one SUMX of price. And this is going to equal SUMX. And what this expression asks for is you take the table you want. So in this case, the table, and then what expression? So in this case, I want to do the same thing with sales, or I'm sorry, with price. Oop, the column is called sales price. Sales price. But what this is gonna do, and it will make more sense once we get to an actual expression, which is gonna happen next, is this is gonna take it at every single row and perform this aggregate. You'll see what that means in an example here in a second. So the same thing, I run this, it's gonna get the same value, that's expected, currency zero. But now, let's go through a process of performing an actual SUMX calculation and why you need it. Here's the money of how to understand the differences of these two things. So what I'm gonna do is my goal now is to get the total sales. And you'll notice that there's multiple levels, so there's every order. So what I'm about to create will validate for the order, but then it won't for the aggregate, because here's how these things work. The sum, it doesn't actually add up all the things below it, it just calculates it at the top. It's gonna be easier to see. So here's an example of where sum won't work and why you need SUMX. So I'll make a new measure. I'm gonna call this sum of total, total sale, okay? And what that means is if I'm just looking at this, I wanna take the sum price that I created there, and I'm gonna multiply it by the quantity. And to do that, I need to get the sum sales quantity and hit enter. That's the total sale. So if I add this, we're gonna see things that are right and things that are wrong. I'm gonna put this to zero. Here's what's right. The row level calculation is correct because it's saying this item, there was two of them for $262. That equals $524. That's completely correct. But what's wrong, and this is why you need the SUMX, is that when you aggregate this up to a group level, the calculation isn't adding all the values of the actual total sales. This 5.9 billion is completely wrong, because what this is doing, it's doing the same thing that we saw below. It's literally taking the sum price, so it's taking 742,000 times 8,028 to get this, but there wasn't 8,000 sales for $742,000 each. So that's where the SUMX is important, and that's the concept of where these aggregations occur. So let's create it and you'll see how to do it correctly or why SUMX is different. New measure. We're gonna call this SUMX total sale, and this is gonna equal now. We're gonna do SUMX. We'll do the exact same thing, but we're gonna say for the table of sales, we want to do the expression of the price times the quantity. And again, the intent of this is to show examples. There's many ways to write certain formulas or anything, but the goal is just so you get and see why SUMX is different than SUM. And if you get that, then this is a success. So I hit enter, I add it in, and set the currency to auto, or the format to auto, to look at the same visual. Now let's look at this. It's working, because what it's doing at the same row level, it's taking the 262 for the total sale and multiplying it by two. But then what's correctly happening with a SUMX, you can see these two numbers are different. And that's the key thing. 3.8 million versus 5.9 billion, a big difference. Because what this SUMX is doing, it's actually adding all these things up. It's calculating that quantity times sale at every single row, and then adding those values up versus calculating it at whatever is returned. That's the difference between SUMX and SUM. So there's gonna be many more videos on DAX Made Easy. You can see this file will be available for you. We're gonna go through count, average, min, max. We're gonna have a whole plethora of a lot of other things as well. But please, if this was valuable, subscribe, like this video, share it, leave any comments or questions, but now you should really get SUMX and how to use it. Have a good one.